Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Washington Center for the Performing Arts. I am not a member of Mercury Rising, and I am definitely not Sam Miller, even though we get mistaken in grocery stores all the time. Unfortunately, the band has asked, they've refused to go on until we update you on the fundraiser that we're having. So it's gonna be a couple of minutes. And while I do that update, feel free to scan the QR codes we have up there. Some of them take you to a website for Ole Theater, which is the new name for the Black Box Theater we recently installed in the Capitol Mall. And one of them takes you to a fundraising page if you would like to donate. Before we get going, we'd like to take a second to have a reminder that it's important to take a moment to acknowledge that the Washington Center and downtown Olympia sit on the traditional lands of the Stay Chass Band of the Squaxin Island Tribe. We also recognize the Medicine Creek's Treaty Tribes and the Nisqually people of this region. As an arts organization, we encourage you to look around our community at the innumerable contributions that Native artists have made, are actively making, and whose histories and cultures are woven into the fabric of our communities. And I would personally invite all of you to do a little bit of research on the history of our community and who lived here. Thank you. And with that said, my name is Kyle Murphy. I am a member of the Board of Directors of Theater Artists Olympia and the founder of Broadway Olympia. And this is a fundraiser for Theater Arts Olympia, by the way, if you didn't know that. If you're here to just see a Rockin' Queen show, you're gonna have to hear about a fundraiser. Sorry about that. Specifically, DAO is their call. Theater Arts Olympia is a group of volunteer theater artists who make theater here in Olympia and have for 20 years. Volunteer means they do it for free. They volunteer their time. They have day jobs. And so fundraisers like this are a big part of how we're able to do what we do. Recently, DAO has taken up residency in the new Black Box Theater in the Capitol Mall that we just installed. They've done four shows there since last summer. The play that goes wrong, the one-act version. The Jacob Marley's Christmas Carol, Baby the Musical, and The Last 5 Years, which just closed today. And they're opening The Half-Life of Marie Curie May 12th. And if everyone in this audience bought a ticket to that, it would sell out instantly. So get out your phones and buy a ticket. That would be wonderful. The best part is the theater is going to be a place for the community to utilize. So if you have shows that you would like to produce, if you're part of another theater company, if you would like to put on an accordion solo, or a one-man production of Rent, the options are endless. Come talk to us. We would really like to get some folks into that theater. And here's where you come in. Every penny we earned from producing this show is going to build out that theater and produce shows in the future. It takes, yeah. I'm gonna tell you how much money that is in a second, but it takes $3,000 to $6,000 per show to produce a play in our little space. And the upgrades we want to do, like adding soundproofing and adding more lights, they're gonna be several thousand dollars over the next year. So it's a big deal what we're doing here. And to all of you who are sitting right about here, I think, who purchased tickets 3 years ago when this was a fundraiser for Broadway Olympia Productions, thank you. And to all of you who purchased tickets in the last 3 months since we announced and said this is now gonna be a fundraiser for Theater Arts Olympia, thank you. And for the 60-ish people who have comp tickets, that's where our donation page is. All right, where are we? Jared, I gotta tell you, man, this is a hell of a birthday party. For those of you who don't know this, 5 years ago, we opened a community theater, musical theater company, rehearsing in the mall. And then 4 years ago, we painted it black. And my friend Jared approached me and said he had a great idea for a 40th birthday party. He wanted to perform as his idol, Freddie Mercury, for all of his friends and family, which there are a lot. So we thought, hey, let's get a venue. And we hatched a plan. We rented the Mini Arts Center at SPSCC, and we sold a couple hundred tickets. And that show was supposed to happen March 12th, 2020. That was 3 years ago, folks. 2 years ago, I honestly did not know if we would ever gather 200 to 300 people in a room together to celebrate the arts. And a year ago, I got a phone call or an email actually from the Washington Center inviting me to a backstage tour of their brand new lighting and sound system, and the wheels started spinning. That was about the time Jared contacted me and said, we're ready to go. Let's do this. Let's switch. Let's go to the big venue and do this at the Washington Center. And today we have a fully functioning Black Box Theater in the mall that will be rebranded as Ole Theater. that is only going to get better and will be a low-cost performance venue that is available to the community. And we're all about to witness an epic 43rd birthday party. So, Olympia, we have some final calculations to do, but I'm very happy to announce that we have raised somewhere in the neighborhood of $10,000 for Theater Artists Olympia. And that's all your support. We really appreciate it. That's awesome. So before we get to the band, we're going to kick it off with a little stand-up comedy. And something else that happened right before the pandemic, I met a gentleman who has come to be my friend over the years. We had planned on doing some little workshops in the spot in the mall. At the time, he was professionally working, counseling unhoused, at-risk youth and trying to become a professional stand-up comedian. That was 3.5 years ago. And he just got back from headlining the Laugh Factory in Chicago. Today, he's a full-time stand-up comedian. He's got an album deal. He's flying all over the country. He was talking about Tennessee and other stuff. And I just want you to know how big his heart is. And what he was doing before this and what he still cares about, because right now, I would like you to give him a welcome as big as his heart, Queen style, and so you know what that means. Yeah. Keep it going for me, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you Olympia's own, Sam Biller!
I bet above you are bummed out. You're like, I thought it was just Queen. Who's this giant fella? My name is Sam Miller. I am a comedian. I am indeed from Olympia, Washington. What a deal, huh? Thank you. A little bit about me. I am 6'6". I'm 360 pounds. I got 2 kids. I've been married 11 years, and I have indeed been clean and sober for 14 years. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, sometimes people ask me, they're like, Sam, what was it like when you were drinking? And I was like, look at this tattoo. That tattoo says, let's dance. So, if any of you guys are wondering out there, if you have a problem with drugs or alcohol, just read your belly tattoo. What does yours say? Because mine says, let's dance. Which is wild because I never enjoyed dancing at all. Yeah, I got in a lot of trouble, man. Just so you know, I have adjusted my set because there are many children here tonight, so it's okay. I'm not gonna say any F words or C words or Q words. I don't know what that one is. Yeah, you guys are very young, that's exciting. But yeah, I'm doing good. I got 2 kids, one of them's on purpose, yeah. Yeah, you all thought I was a loser, I got an on purpose kid, look out. I love my kids, they got big heads though, I got big headed kids. They look like Lego people, it's unfortunate. I know my kids got fat heads because it rains and their shoulders don't get wet. Yeah, you call that God's umbrella, you know. But yeah, I'm doing good. I'm glad I'm sober. I got other problems. It turns out I'm fat. Nobody told me that, you know. It's kind of a bummer. I went to my doctor a few weeks ago, and he told me I had high cholesterol. I was shocked. I was like, me? High cholesterol? Like, all I eat is appetizers. I don't even get to the meal, you know. I got diagnosed with sleep apnea. But I can't afford the machine, so I guess I'm gonna die. My sleep apnea diagnosis, they said that every hour I stop breathing 20 times. And I was like, that's messed up, but on the good side, I start breathing 20 times. You see what I'm saying? How come you didn't bring that up, lady? You know? Like I'm doing pretty good, but... Yeah, they tried to sell me this, like, sleep apnea machine, right? And they said it was $1,500, right? And I can't afford that, you know? And I pull over, the lady's talking to me, I start scrolling through my phone. I found a refurbished one for $600, you know? And I told the lady, I'm like, I'm just going to get the refurbished one because I don't think that guy needs it anymore, you know? Like, it's pretty good, you know? And the lady was like, sir, are you sure you want to put a mask on your face that was on someone else's face? And I was like, lady, I used to drink in Tenino. I think I'll be okay. You know, like if that's what I'm worried about, you know, like, whoa, God, I'll rinse it off. Jeez. I do feel bad for the guy who had that apnea machine before me. Because he stopped breathing 20 times and only started breathing 19, so. It's all right. Yeah, life's a journey. You're like, this is sad. My good stuff, man. Did you guys hear about COVID? Oh, you did? Oh, good, yeah. It was a really, the kid goes, of course we did. Man, nothing gets past you, dude. That was her? One of you dap me up. I can't stay down here forever. I told him I wouldn't do crowd work, but here we are. She goes, of course we did. That's the best answer to that. But yeah, it was rough, man. I remember the first thing I did. Do you remember the first thing you did when the pandemic was easing up? Do you remember how good that felt, right? I took my kids to Wild Waves to make them feel better about me being their dad and COVID and stuff, you know? And I felt so excited. I felt so alive. I'm like, I'm back. You know, I was so excited. Me and the kids, we went to the tallest water slide they had, right? And I'm like, I'm alive, you know? And my kids go down. And they went pretty quick, too, down that water slide because them heads are pushing them, you know? And I'm getting ready to go down, and I'm getting excited, right? Because it's like the first thing, right? Because I want you guys to know from the bottom of my heart, I don't care what you guys think about COVID. I also don't care if you care what I think about COVID. We can all agree that the world is different than it was 3 years ago. You know what I'm saying? Yep. Yeah, yeah. So, right, my kids, they go down, and I'm like, it's time to slide. I'm pumped, right? But I look to the right of that slide, and I saw a sign, a warning sign, and it broke my heart. It said weight limit 300 pounds. And you guys remember at the top of my set, I told you how much I weighed, right? 360, right? But this was mid-pandemic. I was four bills, you know what I mean? I got big. I got knee hurt big. You guys ever get so big your knee hurts? Yeah, and then you get mad at your knee, you know? You're like, what the hell, knee? And your knee's like, I'm doing my best, you know? I'm not the part that has a mouth, you know? Anyway, there's a lifeguard up there, right? And he knows I'm over the limit because I'm not wearing a shirt. But he's in a classic lifeguard conundrum. Because the same men that are too big for the slide are also the same men you don't want to sell that to. You know what I'm saying? He can't do nothing. Also, he's from Kent. He makes minimum wage. He doesn't care. This is Wild Waves. You know what I mean? He's like, go ahead, slide, fatty. I'll just go back to the wave pool, you know? Like, it's like, I don't care. People die on this all the time, you know? This is what happened, right? I looked at that slide. I looked at that lifeguard. I looked at that sign, and I was like, 300 pounds. Close enough. It's not close at all. That's 100 pounds. Right? But I was like, after these last 3 years, I'm sliding, nobody's stopping me, right? I get on that slide, right? And you know the first thing, you guys have been on water slides before, right? The first thing they do is they got that dip to get you going. And I hit that dip, and I was going. It was scary. I didn't know you could accelerate like that without an engine. I was like, whoa! Just me and Newton, right? I'm just cruising down this thing, right? And they had a long straightaway, right? And I'm flying. I'm going way too fast, right? And I actually grew up in Spanaway, so I'm wearing basketball shorts. These are the rules. If you grew up in rural Pierce County, you got to wear basketball shorts to Wild Waves. All right? I didn't come up with that. Okay? I was born into that. So you sit in your tower, you Cooper Point folks, all right? So, I know y'all are out here. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. This is the Washington Center. I know where I'm at. You know. Yeah. I was in Puyallup last night for 30 people. I'm doing all right. You know. But anyway, I'm sliding, right? And those basketball shorts, they are working their way up. Okay. They're not in my butt, but they are at the door. You know. They're like an impatient FedEx driver. Like, who's in there? You know. Yeah. So at this point, it's just butt meat to plastic. And it's heating up. It's heating up. And I'm 20 feet in. This is a 100-foot water slide. I am 20 feet in, and they're already uncomfortably warm. You know? And I'm like, what's going to happen? Are we talking steam? Like, what are we going to do, right? That's heating up and heating up. Do you remember 2 years ago when we had that heat wave and it hit like 108? And it was like 5 p.m., it's 108, and like, that sucks. But you know what's scarier than that? Is when it's 10 a.m. and it's 86. And that's how I'm feeling, you know? I'm scared, right? My buns are heating up, but I got smart. You know what I did? I started switching butt cheek to butt cheek. I was like, whoop, 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 whoop. Yeah, now it worked. It gave the water a chance to get back under there, right? Cooled it down, you know? It reminded me, like, you ever go to Jack in the Box at, like, 2 a.m., and, like, you're all tired and, like, hungover, you know, and, like, you get those jalapeno poppers, because those are slamming, you know, and you get one of those jalapeno poppers, and, like, you know it's too hot and that you should wait, but you're like, I'm sad, and you just eat one, you know, and then it's too hot and it's burning your mouth, and then you're like, ooh, yeah, and then the lady's like, Sam, you're not allowed at this Jack in the Box, and it's like, screw you, that was a long time ago, you know. I can still go to the West Side one, but not the Plum Street one. That's the way it goes. Listen, I'm doing all right, all right? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank God for turnover. That's another sign you might have a problem with drugs or alcohol. Have you ever been kicked out of a Jack in the Box? That hurt. But anyway, right, I'm cruising, right? So it helped and it cooled down. But then Olympia, this is where it gets scary, because I started hitting those corners. And there's nothing I can do. I can't stop. You know, I'm just going faster and faster. And I'm glad my butt's not on fire, but now I'm worried for my life. You know? And I see that first corner, and there's nothing I can do to stop it, right? And you know it's coming right for you, right? So I took a deep breath. I went, and then when I went around the courses, the corner, the G-forces pushed it out. I went around that corner, and I went, because it was like the front of me wanted to get to the back of me, but the middle of me was in the way, you know, and I hit that corner, right, and then immediately back to the left, right, and I hit this corner to the left, and it shot me up the right side of that slide. I went so high up the right side of that slide that I looked over my arm, over the side of the slide. I could see both my kids. It crossed my mind that this was maybe the last time, you know? I thought about saying goodbye, but there's no time, you know what I mean? And this is where it gets serious. Because what they did is they went from the left immediately to a right. And when that corner stopped, my downward momentum turned into sideways momentum. And then that corner hit, and it shot me up the left side. Luckily, somebody had put a barrier there. Because I think another fatty had snuck on before me. And thank you for your service. You know, there goes my hero. That nameless, faceless hero that flew off that water slide and landed in Tukwila, probably. But anyway, I shot up the left side of that water slide, and this is what happened. This is the bad part. I went so high up the left side of that water slide that my left butt cheek hit a dry spot. And I will never be the same. I'm from Olympia. I love people. I think different races, different genders, different sexualities. Like, we should all come together. But god dang, we need to keep these water slides separate. There are water slides and there are traditional slides, and they need to stay apart from each other. Because what happened, my left butt cheek hit that dry spot, but my right butt cheek was still slide. My left butt cheek, it hit that spot, and it made a noise. And not just a noise for me, a noise for most of South King County, you know? And it's not what you think. It started with a squeak, but then it morphed to a chirp. I hit that dry spot, it went, right? And my right butt cheek's still going, but my left butt cheek's trying to stop. So I got one butt cheek going this way, one butt cheek going that way, and my butt was in the middle, like, what do I do? You know, like, he was lost. Yeah, my butthole was like a kid in a bad divorce, you know? Yeah. I was like, Dad lets me stay up late, but Mom's got Uncrustables, you know? Like, there's always one guy in that crowd that hates that joke. You're like, oh, I should have got Uncrustables. But luckily, it did slow me down a little bit, and then I entered the tube portion of the slide, because they were like, what's this water slide need? And I was like, off ramps. They were like, how about a roof? And I was like, all right. The roof part was cool because they didn't have to worry about popping out, right? But now I'm dark and there's like a roof and it's like, it reminds me of the sewer and like I'm in the sewer again, you know? And yeah, and I didn't work for the water department. I was exploring. Don't recommend it. But anyway, I go around some more corners and then I finally saw it, the light at the end of the tunnel. And I thought about the last 3 years for a second, you know what I mean? What feels better than seeing that light at the end of the tunnel? And I knew, this is a true story, I knew I was gonna be okay and that felt really good. But here's the thing, I'm going too fast. And just like in the beginning, they got another dip to get me going. But I was going, you know? So I was like, I need to slow down. And I remember the lifeguard, he told me, he was like, make sure you cross your legs. And I'm like, good idea, because I'll go faster. I'll be more hydrodynamic, like a dolphin or a torpedo. But I was like, I'm not trying to go fast. I'm trying to slow down. So not only am I going to uncross my legs, I got my feet, and I put them on the roof of the slide, which did slow me down quite a bit. But Olympia, this is going to be the learning portion. That leg crossing stuff has nothing to do with speed and everything to do with safety, because I hit that water hard, and I hit that butt first, and a lot of water went in my butt. A lot of water. And here's the weird thing with water in your butt, is you don't really know how much went in there. Like, I don't have lines, it's not like Pyrex. But I can give you a range. It was more than a cup, less than a half gallon. Somewhere in there. I'm gonna tell you guys something real quick. I do comedy, it's my full-time job. It's been an honor to be here tonight. This is my favorite place in the world. I love Olympia. Out in the lobby, I am going to sell shirts, and I'm going to run out, I hope. And I'm just really proud of my shirts, because my shirts say, Sam Miller, let's dance. And it's my belly tattoo. So, yeah. I thought about telling just one dirty joke to change these kids' lives forever, but I don't think I'm going to do it. So, because you know what? You know who's here today? I want to say something, too. This doesn't happen a lot, but give it up for my son, Buddy and Oliver. They're up in the top balcony. Everybody say hi to them. Cool, yeah. And yeah, that's the end of my thing. You guys excited about this Queen stuff, man? You guys ready to go? Well, hey, listen, I'm going to see you guys out in the lobby ever. You guys have been fantastic. It is my distinct honor right now to bring to the stage, give it up for Jared Nace from Mercury Rising.
Here for the Queen show?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. My mom's in the front row. Some serious pressure. And it's my birthday! Okay, well, I guess it's time to get down to my birthday suit. Don't worry, it's sort of family friendly. All right, I'm gonna need a little musical inspiration for this part. Can you help me out, Mike? The most important one. Okay, let's do it. Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive, and the world will turn it inside.
Thank you.
just a skinny lad. Never knew no good from bad, but I knew life before I left my nursery. Left alone with Big Fat Betty. She was such a naughty nanny. You big woman, you done made me mad at me. Hey! Here, been on Veterans of the Stage. This is Bruce Hazel and Amy Shepherd. You'll hear a lot of them. We take turns singing lead in this band because there's a plethora of good vocal talent. All right, Amy's up next. Let's do this.
to break free. I want to break free.
To introduce the rest of these talented folks up here. We've got our musical maestro on the keyboards and acoustic guitar, David Lang. Our supersonic bassist, Mike Foisey. This man drove from Yakima for all of our rehearsals. That's bonkers. Thank you, Mike, for being here. The heartbeat of the band, Andy Garness on drums. And last, but certainly not least, my good buddy Michael Hemming on lead guitar. I've known this guy since about middle school. One of my very first impressions of him was doing the Michael J. Fox routine at Back to the Future at a school assembly. You know, the whole scooting on his back. Didn't miss a note. And then in high school on a choir tour, we serenaded baristas at Pike Street Market for sticky buns. I consider that my first paid gig. All right, this next song is called Doing All Right. It's actually originated by a band called Smile, the predecessor to Queen. Lead singer of Smile, Tim Staffel, decided to quit the band even though he had super talented people like Brian May and Roger Taylor. I don't know if you heard the band that he joined, they're called Humpy Bong. Anyway, we're gonna do this tune next. And all I gotta say to Tim is thank you so much for quitting the band. Otherwise, who knows if we would ever gotten to meet Freddie Mercury. Yesterday, my life was in ruin. Today, I know what I'm
she'll be waiting for the sun. Anyway, I got to hide, going back to where the skies are blue, going back to find the one.
taken my love, and now you leave me, love of my life, can't you see? Bring it back, don't take it away from me, because you don't know what it means to me.
Thank you. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. Ow! Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey! Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey, hey!
In a pretty cabinet, let them eat cake, she says, just like Marie Antoinette. A built-in remedy from Khrushchev and Kennedy. At any time, an invitation you can decline. Caviar and cigarettes, well-versed in etiquette, extraordinarily nice, she's a killer. She's as willing as, playful as a pussycat. Momentarily out of action, temporarily out of gas. She'll absolutely drive you wild. She's out to get you. She's a killer.
work till I ache in my bones. At the end of the day, I take home my time, pay on my own. And I go down on my knees and I start praying till tears run down.
Thanks, Mom.
Somebody to love.
Get round to it, I ain't ready. thing called love. Crazy little thing called love.
Crazy little thing called love. Crazy little thing called love.
It's a kind of magic. One dream, one soul, one prize, one goal, one golden glance of what should be.
Thank you.
and gentlemen, Mr. Michael Hedman. Hey, Brucey, you want to sing a song with me?
Why, yes, Jared, I would love to. You'll recognize this one. Maybe. Uh-oh.
Pressure on the people, people on the streets. Nay, need a little. Okay. Shipping around, put my brains on the floor. Leave all the doors, it never rains but it pours. Need a little, need a little. Like a blind man, sat on the fence, but it don't work. Keep coming up with love, but it's so slashed and torn.
What?
to me one more time.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life is just begun, and now I've gone and thrown it all away. Mama, ooh, didn't mean to make you cry. If I'm not back again this time tomorrow, carry on, carry on, as if nothing really matters. Too late, my time has come. Sent shivers down my spine, body's aching all the time. Goodbye, everybody. I've got to go. Gotta leave you all behind and face the truth.
What's new? Radio song.
know what to do. Buddy, you're a boy making big noise, playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place. Your banner all over the place.
We'll be right back.
Are you ready?